Hello guys, my name is Russian Badger, and the way that I think about the new patch in my brain is just like this. It's just like in Training Day when Ethan Hawke asks Denzel Washington, "When are you gonna show me that shoot 'em up stuff?" And Denzel Washington says to him, "Nah dog, that day is dead, we don't roll like that no mo." That is essentially what I think of the new patch. DICE just took this game and turned it on its head. I'm not gonna say if that's good or bad, but everything is completely different. And I'll talk about the changes throughout the entire video, but okay, off the top of my head, gunplay, totally different. Recoil values, accuracy values, even in some cases damage values, totally different. The added effect of suppression has a huge influence on gunfights. The armor is completely different. A tank goes down much, much easier post-patch compared to pre-patch. Those things are not as tough as they were. Even the aircraft, the tweaking and the changing of the Igla and the Stinger, making them more lethal but giving them less range, everything has been changed. Like, this is a completely new battlefield, and I have a lot to talk to you about in terms of the completely new battlefield, but I have to say, I am such a Carl sometimes. Like, look at my accuracy here. Overall, I have just been playing too much Rainbow Six Vegas 2 this week with Kia, and that game is completely different.
Holy shit, these meals are fucking expensive.
Roger that.
$10 for some hot dogs. They're like three of the same panini and they're all different prices. Why even drink $9? Sandini's paninis. Why would you pay $2.75 for... Why is chili more expensive than a burrito? You could buy dragons and scorpions and cities. Or tuna roll. It's $2.75 for a taco. $10 for- they sell scorpions here?
Yeah, that's essentially why my accuracy is off. Switching between the sensitivity of Rainbow Six Vegas 2 and Battlefield 3 is very different, and I do apologize about my accuracy being off, but I didn't have a whole lot of time to adjust because this game was shortly after I got off Rainbow Six Vegas 2, but that game is so much fun to play with Kia. It's just so much fun because you would think that special operations are all about, you know, using night vision goggles and being tactical, but it's more so just about, why is chili more expensive than a burrito? And Sandini's paninis, just, that game is so humorous to play with Kia. And I did not understand the Klaus monster. Okay, look at this guy. Okay. I don't think I ever killed Mad Pennywise when he was not prone. Like, that guy was prone the entire game. It's like he adopted this attitude of, I figure I'm gonna go ahead and take a nap now. And he just napped or slept the entire game. He was never not prone. And it was very odd to see at the time. So I got a second gentleman over here. And then look at Carl. Come here, Carl. Carl, just run around the rock. We're all waiting for you. We're all come on, Carl. Good evening, Carl. We've been expecting you in the Arizona Ranger with the big iron on his hip. I know that guy was not expecting me. He was not expecting me to turn around, but look at this guy over here. I don't know what it was. Like, was this... At long last, a friendship has been brought to an end by Kung Fu Treachery. I don't know if it was Kung Fu Treachery. I don't know if he opened the door, got on the floor, and then he walked the dinosaur, but I could not hit him. I don't know if I'm just inaccurate. Maybe he's just impervious to my bullets while he's doing the dinosaur dance. I just couldn't hit him. I apologize, but allow me to show you this. Look at this. How welcoming are those what are those server rules? How welcoming. How nice of you. And that's not the first time that people talk trash at me. Like, that happens all the time. Thanks for being so nice about me playing in the tank. Thanks, man. That happens all the time. Just I don't get what how malevolent the chat always is. I don't get the chats in Battlefield 3, but I get my chicken sandwich and some waffle fries, and I stuck that love in 44 beneath my head. Get that guy, I get this guy, and I can't get them all. I cannot get them all. Like, this happens so often to me in this gameplay. You'll notice this was so frustrating. I had zero backup or blackout for my team. Zero backup. Like, I knew from about Well, at this point right here, 18 tickets, I knew I was going to have to carry. So I said, how do you carry? You get in the Amtrak, you shove it directly at the objective, and you win. It became obvious very early on. Like, I think when I first entered the game, it was pretty obvious that this was like an extended ticket server. Like, there's at least over 100 tickets in the server, and if you don't get an objective and the server is like 120 tickets or 150 tickets, your team is awful. So I just basically, I declared to my team, you know what, guys? You rack discipline. And if you raff, you ruse. You guys are going to lose if I don't carry you. So I said, I'm going to shove the Amtrak directly at A. I'm going to get out. What are you doing, Carl? Why would you shoot an RPG directly at the ground when I'm right in front of you? And sadly, I could not get back into the Amtrak. That, like, first, the front side is hard to get in. Look at this tank. Look at this tank. Oh, don't mind me, guys. I'm just dropping it unannounced. Somehow we got the objective. And just so you know, this is not the first time this happens. And this is the type of game that I enjoy. Oh, I get my two-piece. I don't get my biscuit. I'm a little sad about that, but I don't get my biscuit. This is not the first time this happens, though. This is my most enjoyable form of Battlefield gameplay. When I have to carry the team or I arm with, like, one ticket left, I think that's the best form of Battlefield. Despite the fact that I got blown up by a gentleman with the very, very courteous name of Uterus Punch, it doesn't matter, because we got the objective anyways, and I think that is definitely my favorite form of Battlefield. When I carry a team, or when things get really close and I somehow pull it off, that is my favorite form of Battlefield. I have no clue how these catfish find Battlefield enjoyable, and oh, look at me! I got three other my best friends in my squad, and we raped the opposing team! That was so easy, and how is that fun? I don't get it. That's why I like playing by myself for the most part. Like, I don't know, when you squad up, things just get so much easier. I'm not a huge fan of the squad play. Just so you guys know, I don't find that type of Battlefield as enjoyable, and please get out of the spawn. Like, you catfish, stop staying in the spawn. And there's another gentleman. Like, look at this guy. Okay. So I know that the Amtrak is a critical piece, and despite the fact I'm not a good driver because my Maserati does 185, I lost my license and now I don't drive. Okay, I get out. Good evening, Carl. Guten Abend, guten Tag, guten Nacht. Like, I don't get it. I don't get why so many people linger in the spawn. Now, granted, I think that it's okay to linger in the spawn when your team is extremely bad. Like, when your team is extremely bad and you somehow have to sort of spawn linger or spawn camp just to cut down their tickets to have a chance of winning, I think that's appropriate, but it's just goofy. And, okay, this gentleman right here, Bumblebee, or whatever his name is, B47, he reminded me of this other gentleman on Operation Metro. He reminded me of this gentleman by... His name is I Want a Soft Taco, and I killed this guy so many times. Sometimes I run into games where I just kill people over and over and over and over again. And this is one of those situations. Look, I want a soft taco. Okay, eins, und dann zwei, und dann I'm drei, und dann vier. I get him four straight. No, don't revive him again. I get him a fifth time. Oh no, I thought I got him a fifth time, but like. That has happened to me so many times. I just get Bumblebee over and over and over again. And it's just goofy. Because that guy gets really sad later on. He gets so sad later on. Like, he even goes accusations later on. And I don't know why. There's been like a rapid influx of that sort of accusation talk. And I know it's... Obviously it's not hacks. Like, the actual hacks are not really what occur in this game. But this game was just so goofy. I just didn't understand how that game worked. And I mean goofy in the sense that, Wesley, sit your $5 ass down before I make change, snipes. And, okay, this is what I mean by goofy. I didn't understand how these gentlemen, especially Killer B47, good morning, he's like the ultimate Carl of all time. Like, I just didn't get him. I didn't understand how they were getting mad at me for, they were accusing me of cheating or like hacking or something. And then they were running to this exact same rock over here over and over and over again like an assembly... I didn't get it. They were like running here over and over and over like an assembly line just to have me shoot them in the face again. There's Killer B again. Like, I don't get it. I don't get it. At least I Want a Soft Taco didn't complain about it. I killed him like four straight times in a row. He didn't complain about it, but... I didn't understand their logic, but my fofo makes sure all your kids don't grow, and I get that gentleman there. Dr. Clawdaddy. These guys have the goofiest names. Like, I was just reviewing some of the names of some of the, like, some of you that join me on the live stream and elsewhere, and, like, names such as Muffin Pirate and I Want a Soft Taco, and, like, you guys have some of those creative names that I really love, and the Arizona Ranger with a big iron on his hip yet again, and I do that from time to time anyways. Like, you would think that I would aim down sight, but, oh, this is where I ran into trouble. I'm out of bullets for everything. I forgot to reload, and I'd somehow get hit finally, but that is one major difference. You could tell that both of those gentlemen were very, very inaccurate, and also here, number one squad. Do you want to spawn on that cloth monster or that cloth monster that is, like, 120 meters back from the objective? That's just wonderful. But one thing that you'll notice is that automatic fire is so much worse. It is so much worse. And the... Okay, I have to mention this first. The suppression. The suppression is a little over the top, if you ask me. Like, it's almost like Nicolas Cage, like your eyes are just being destroyed when you're being shot at. Like, you have zero accuracy. Like, you get shot at by, like, a few little, like, 9mm bullets, and it's just, oh, all of a sudden you go Nicolas Cage, like, oh god, my eyes! My eyes! No, not the bees! Oh, that... Coincidentally, I kill Killer Bee while I mention Nicolas Cage freaking out about the bees, but I'm sure you guys have seen that movie, you know. Oh god, my eyes! Yeah, like, that's essentially what happens when you get suppressed. When you get suppressed, you're so inaccurate. Like, your bullets go everywhere. Like, everywhere. And, okay, here is where it starts. Here is where it starts. Let's check the chat, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, look at me! Figures the Russian hacks. Well, number one, I'm not even remotely Russian in any way, shape, or form. I believe my heritage is German, English, and French for the most part. I speak German, I'm from Canada, I live in the United States. I have nothing Russian about me, but okay, I knew I had to flank. Like, okay, that's pretty inaccurate automatic fire, so I get one gentleman. I get the two-piece. I get my biscuit with a 44 mag, but I'm just out of bullets again. I can't get every single one of them. Like, this was my frustration in this game. That's when I died. I died when... Look at all that lurking gab fest. Look at that gab fest, bro. That's like six guys all inside the objective. Now, okay, granted. If a gab fest is ever morally permissible, I'm sure it's permissible in that situation. If you're camping on the objective, like, it's better to do that than a bunch of cloth monsters just sitting on a rooftop. But I just could not get them all. Like you recognize, sometimes you feel like Superman in games, right? You feel like, yeah, I can kill the entire opposing team, I can just exterminate them. You can usually get around three or four, maybe five if you're lucky, but you're eventually going to run out of ammo, especially with the setup of an assault rifle and a magnum. And look, kick Russian ban. He really wanted to ding-dong-manu, ding-dong-manu. He said basically end of Rhine, and he wanted to ding-dong-ban me, but I said, I don't think you have admin powers, and there's no vote kick on this server, so the joke's on you, bro, Chacho. And I finally saw that guy's shadow, okay? I decided to sort of pin myself back and try to snipe out anybody who that was inside, and sort of when they poked their head out, I would just destroy them, and that was my main goal in this section. I just wanted to, overall, I wanted to make sure that nobody was... Oh my gosh. I cannot even tell you how frustrating claymores are. Just like one claymore destroying you in the most awkward locations, that's very, very annoying. Now, granted, you're probably going to tell me, why you no run squad flak, Russian Badger? Well, I usually run ammo because I usually stay alive, or I stay alive for quite... You guys will notice, I stay alive for extended periods of time very, very often, and I need that ammo most of the time. And I really can't afford to run squad flak, but seriously, one-shot claymores, I think those are not exactly a great part of the game. I'm not going to whine about it. I'm not going to say, nerf this, nerf that. I don't like people that bicker about nerfing certain things, but I don't exactly enjoy claymores, if you ask me. And, okay, I get this gentleman here. I go back to the safe haven of the Amtrak, and I basically said, okay, this is how we're going to win the game. I'm going to shove this to the back of the objective, and I'm going to distract as many guys as I can, because I know they're all engineers. They all want the Amtrak kill. I got one gentleman and two gentlemen with a magnum, but this frustrated me so much. That guy had a clear... That engineer... Give me all sim! Okay, that guy had a clear shot directly on that guy through the... Whatever that stone wall is, and he didn't go for it. He tried to sneak up and take the guy's sandwich. Now, granted, I guess that's a good idea. I guess we still got the objective, but that's why I think I go for sandwiches a lot less. And Mad Company 2 is a quick little, give me a sandwich, and then you're done. It's not like, oh, I walk up, I take you on a small seafood dinner, and then we go see Game of Thrones, and then we watch some more HBO, and then I knife you. It's like a quick knife. It's not as effective in terms of staying alive in combat. So, I mean, I could bicker all day about, oh, he should have shot him, he should have did this, he should have did that, but we won overall. Despite the fact that I did put my team on my back, I did not arm the last two objectives, but I think I killed enough. I exterminated enough people to make a profound effect, and I'm glad that I can upload a gameplay like this where it's, I had some resistance. Not, oh, I squatted up with three of my pals and we steamrolled this team. Yeah, it was so great. Nobody wants to see that, bro. It's so commonplace now that squads just destroy opposing teams. It's not even great. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. I will see you guys next time. Your bonus clip is, I think it, okay, your bonus clip is going to be some great gameplay with a Magnum, and then I take down a helicopter from a very far distance. So hopefully you enjoy that. I will see you guys next Friday. Auf Wiedersehen und bis bald und later.